Sometimes, when I make a great effort, I can remember her scent, the sweetness of her breath. Serena. Serena? Why can't I see you more clearly? Why can't I even remember?
Ja, hallo und herzlich willkommen zu Serena, einem Spiel aus der Reihe Rätsel, Horror, verstörende Point-and-Click-Adventure. Und ja, das Spiel kommt von Senscape. Ist mehr so als Community-Projekt gedacht. Es ist halt nicht sehr groß. Was bedeutet, wir haben hier nur diesen Raum, in dem wir uns aufhalten können.
I still can't understand. Even the features of her face feel hazy and distant, like remnants of a broken dream.
Ja, und ja, wie gesagt, wir bewegen uns halt nur in diesem Raum, haben hier mehr oder weniger Rätsel, sage ich jetzt mal, zu lösen. Im Grunde geht es darum, wir haben unser Gedächtnis verloren und es geht sich hauptsächlich um diese Frau auf dem Foto.
Here, in her private refuge. Must be something that reminds me of her.
Und also das Spiel kommt von Senscape, ist kostenlos auf Steam zu erwerben. Das heißt, zu erwerben, man kann sich dort runterladen und sich das mal angucken. Von Senscape kommt auch Asylum, wo ich schon das Review oder das Preview.
So much. How is it possible that I can't remember her face?
Ja, ist in Ordnung. Asylum. Von Senscape, wo ich schon ein Preview gemacht habe, was nächstes Jahr erst rauskommt. Von der Grafik-Engine ist es dieselbe, es handelt sich über einen Dragon. Und ja, das ist einfach nur, man kann es als Vorspiel ansehen, was die Grafik-Engine angeht und halt dieses allgemeine Spielprinzip. Der Sprecher ist derselbe, wie es auch später in Asylum sein wird. Und ich habe es schon mal ein bisschen angespielt. Wie gesagt, es geht um diese Frau auf dem Foto. Und es ist etwas verstörend. Also von der Atmosphäre her auch und so weiter.
Perhaps in her dresser. Or something that she liked.
Ja, hat sein Gedächtnis verloren. Es geht hier um die Frau und wir werden das jetzt mal einfach mal spielen. Es wird viel geredet in diesem. Ich will es nicht Demo nennen, es ist ja ein fertiges Spiel, aber es wird halt viel geredet, er erzählt halt viel und wir versuchen jetzt halt dieses Bild wieder klar werden zu lassen, sodass er sich daran erinnern kann. Man kann dieses Spiel nicht pausieren, das heißt, da müsste er jetzt durch. Wenn man Escape drückt, beendet sich das Spiel. Es gibt auch kein Menü, es gibt kein gar nichts.
I miss her so much. How is it possible that I can't remember her face?
Ja, wir fangen hier gleich an. Wie gesagt, ich kann nicht beenden. Das heißt, ihr müsst euch das jetzt antun, also, egal wie lange es dauert. Ja, dann wollen wir einfach mal gucken. Wie gesagt, es wird viel geredet, viel erklärt. Und wir versuchen jetzt halt, dieses Bild wieder aufzudecken, sodass sich der Proband daran erinnern kann, an seine Serena.
The furniture came with the cabin. Considering how off the beaten path this place is, that helped make up our mind. Sometimes she would brush her leg against mine under the table when we were eating. A curious, sensual thrill.
Und man wird auch später feststellen, dass ihm auch der Staub, der hier so in der Gegend rumfliegt, nicht gefällt. Wie schon in Asylum der Fall war, aber ja, schauen wir mal einfach mal.
So many afternoons spent in this armchair.
Come sit with me. I want to talk and cuddle.
What did we talk about? Damn this fallible memory of mine. The most comfortable spot in the cabin, well, along with the bed, of course. This window never got much attention, Then again, the view isn't nearly as spectacular. Priorities, right? I guess it's covered with grease and grime from cooking, mostly. There's probably nothing out there that I want to see, anyway. All the stuff I care about is inside.
Well, genau.
Except for Serena.
Natürlich. So, wir haben hier ein Bücherregal. Mit sehr interessanten Büchern. The Unfortunate Life of a Chocolate Saint. Ja. The Art of Droning. Hm. Bestimmt. Sehr interessant. Dream of Snow.
So much wisdom and happiness in this bookcase. My life would have been much poorer without all this. The smell of old books is intoxicating. What happens to wood pulp as it ages gives it that distinctive vanilla smell.
Was haben wir hier noch? So you want to be purple tentacle. Ja. English grammar for beginners.
I loved it when we took down one of my favorites and curled up on the bed to read together as the wind howled outside on cold winter nights. Most of the books are mine, but all of hers are still here too. A lot of rarities and special editions here.
Würde ich meinen bei den Buchtiteln.
I didn't lend out my Necronomicon, did I? No. Of course not. Most of the books are mine, but all of hers are still here, too. Sharing meals with a good red wine was one of the great pleasures in our relationship, especially in the intimacy of this cabin. We had such a wonderful time dining in this cabin. Serena loved to experiment with her cooking. Truth be told, not all the cooking she did was a resounding success. We agreed to never attempt doing ravioli again.
You silly dolt. Here, give me that. Don't be such a child.
I think it dates from the colonial era, probably brought over by the pilgrims. It belongs in a museum. An archaeologist could excavate the layers of food forever welded onto this and learn about the days when other beings ruled the earth. The table is worn but sturdy, just like our relationship was. Or is. I just don't know anymore.
True friends.
Something draws me to this trunk. Is it the memories locked within? Or something else? We use this trunk to store trinkets and papers, but I can't help thinking there's something of importance inside. It's too painful. I want to, but not yet.
Na gut, machen wir das halt später.
Come, love, with peace in your heart. Said Niav of the ice-blue eyes. Blue eyes. It's based on an Irish folktale. Warrior poet Oisin goes to Tírnanog, a Celtic otherworld known as the Land of Youth and Promise. Niav is of the Fey folk, the fair ones, fairies. Weird mix of doggerel and artistry. The elemental imagery is evocative, but the language and structure are a bit quaint. Still, some lines jump out at you. I've always been drawn to things that are kind of both good and bad at the same time. Maybe because that's so like life. My grandma introduced me to these old legends when I was just a kid, in between stories of what she could still remember of her childhood in the old country. Weird mix of doggerel and artistry. The elemental imagery is evocative, but the language and structure are a bit quaint. Still, some lines jump out at you.
Das können wir schon.
Our dining table. Quite modest, but if it ain't broke, don't fix it. She made this with her own hands. She was really good.
Look what I made, hun, in case we ever need to sweep something under the carpet. See the pattern of yellow squares? It's from this rug I remembered from my nursery. I must have been like 3 or 4, but it always stuck with me.
And no trap door under there, just more creaky floor. I always resisted the temptation to sweep things under there when it was my turn to tidy up.
The rug's all crooked again. Can you help me straighten it out?
And no trap door under there, just more creaky floor. Our refuge from the world. A place of warmth and passion. Sometimes we joked we needed to be so far out in the woods because that's how our sex life was. Far out. The furniture came with the cabin, but the bedclothes we brought with us. A place like this needs some luxury. But without her, there are no monsters under the bed. I guess they're all in my head. I feel too restless to sleep right now.
Okay.
What a large armoire for our admittedly Spartan needs. She uses most of it. We all have our skeletons in the closet, but not Serena. She was perfect. I'm not sure why, but I don't feel like opening it. The sole thought of it drains what little energy I have left in me. Maybe later. There's nothing of interest inside the closet anyway. For some reason, light bulbs wouldn't last long in this lamp. I never looked into it. 2 days, 3 days tops, and bam, a brand new light bulb would burn out. Whenever her lamp didn't work, Serena would come by my side to read. A few moments later, she would lay her head down on my chest and fall asleep. The only reason this lampshade gathered less dust than the other one was that we had to keep putting new bulbs in this one. Because of a wiring problem or whatever, this one always starts smelling sharply of metal after being on for a while. Considering what a strong odor of metal this one gives off when in use, I guess we were lucky never to have an accident. The only reason this lampshade gathered less dust than the other one was that we had to keep putting new bulbs in. She used to keep magazines, paperback novels, usual stuff on these nightstands when we were staying here.
Good night, love.
She would always bring her reading material like I did. Why are these nightstands so empty? Dust everywhere.
Da ist es, Dust. Wie in Asylum. Der hat ein Problem mit Staub, aber richtig.
The amount of dust on it might make me hack up a lung. It's full of little scratches and gouges. Dust everywhere. She is fairly religious, not me. I'm the cold and cynical bastard. But I don't remember that ever being an issue between us. She always thought our relationship was a blessing. God, how I miss her. No longer the cynical asshole, I guess. Her faith came as a surprise to me. She was never prudish about sex, so I just didn't expect it. I guess, no, I don't want to read right now. Especially not a Bible. I have no need for the words in there. I don't feel like being admonished by a deity right now. No, I don't want to read right now. Especially, she adored all things of nature. I remember her long walks out in the woods. Curiously, we never brought many plants inside the cabin. We were surrounded by so many outside. I guess we were saturated by them. At least I was. Maybe I should have let her bring some plants inside. She liked them a lot. A plant is a plant. Beautiful to some, boring to others. They say these things are alive. If they are, it must be a horrible existence, confined in their own silent, dark world. We have much more interesting things than this plant inside the cabin, like my books. A plant is a plant, beautiful to some, boring to others.
So, gibt's hier in der Ecke noch was?
I don't sleep well without Serena next to me. Both a blessing and a curse, I suppose. There are no monsters under the bed.
Okay, das müssen wir schon.
I always resisted the temptation to sweep things under there when it was my turn to tidy up. It's a beautiful day, though there's an unnatural calm surrounding the area. I've always loved the hazy afternoon shades of this place. It's deep into summer, so there's a few hours left until it gets dark. The sunlight is so bright here. In other circumstances, this would have been the perfect afternoon for us. There's a crack in this window from a tantrum she threw some time ago. It wasn't the only thing she threw. Not exactly perfect soundproofing. The sunlight can be confusing, oppressive, as if pregnant with some ill omen. Or is the stress finally catching up with me?
Ja, der Proband scheint etwas, ich würde es nicht sagen wahnsinnig, aber es ist schon ein gewisser geistiger Verfall ist schon festzustellen.
The sunlight is so bright
ja,
here.
Schon.
Another, the clock is a trophy from our flea market adventures. Chalk this particular purchase up to every cabin needs one. The ticking begins to feel homey after a while. The first night was a nightmare, though. Time never mattered much to us while we were hiding from the rest of the world here. As long as we were together and happy. The clock has always been rather autonomous. No matter how many times we've wound it up, it keeps going out of sync. Actually, I think it might have gone out of sync again. No trusting this clock. I wonder what time it is. As if it mattered. The clock has always been rather autonomous. Unlike its sibling, this lamp would last for months. We brought the lamps with us when we got this place all those years ago. They were from a garage sale. The sun is streaming through the window. No reason to turn this on. All these metaphors and similes in my head. Light of my life. Make light. Wait, that's another kind of light. A lamp is a lamp, but to a writer, every mundane item triggers connections, and that leads to more. It seemed like neither of us could bother to properly wipe the lampshades. All these metaphors and similes in my head, light of my life, make light. Wait, that's another kind of light.
Gut, hier ist gar nichts drin. Ist gut.
They prevent my blood pressure from skyrocketing. Doctor's orders. And Serena's. I'm generally not fond of taking medication. I find it hard to believe ingesting a few chemicals will do me much good in the long run.
Don't forget your pill, hun. I know you'd rather not, but you know it's for the best.
Beta blockers. I have high blood pressure. I'm only supposed to take these before meals. Not a big fan of them. They do tend to alleviate my headaches, though. Beta blockers. I have high blood pressure. Hers. I used it, too, when shaving. There's only an outhouse, and for some reason, whoever erected the rickety thing didn't think to include wall-to-wall mirrors. So, this came in handy. Should I dust for fingerprints? I might if I were in a detective story.
Sind wir doch hier, quasi.
After all these years, it permanently smells of her and her perfume. The last thing I need now is to see myself in the mirror. I must look awful. There's dust on this, too. It's everywhere. After all these years, it permanently smells of her and her perfume. These keys are for the cabin and the car. If the keys are here, does she have her spare? I should probably stay here in case she doesn't. Did she even have her own spare? We also have a key for the outhouse, but can't be bothered to keep it anywhere other than under that rock next to the thing. No one comes here anyway. We did have a night prowler once who left a mark inside the outhouse, but we rarely lock it anyway. I never noticed it before, but There's some rust on the ring. Should get a new one. We also have a key for the outhouse, but can't be bothered to keep it anywhere other than under that rock next to the thing. No one comes here anyway.
Oh, I'm brief.
Dearest, how do I say any of this? I like your way with words, but if I don't write this, I don't know what I'll do. My life feels so unreal now, dreamlike, but wonderfully so. Let me try, even if clumsily. The hours I spent with you when we last met are precious to me. I was so lost such a short time ago. Everything seemed drained of color and feeling. I think we were meant to find each other, to bring meaning to our lives again, make sense of the confusion shrouding both of us. When we stepped into the crystal silence of the snowy woods, away from the chatter of the guests, all nature seemed expectant, as if holding its breath, witnessing a rare moment of something infinitely better than what life in the ordinary run of things has to offer. Do you remember how the light crust of the snow glittered in the reflected light of the country house? How the copse of trees in which we walked was haloed with a magical aura? I felt the chill of the night air, and you opened your coat and enfolded me in your arms, and we hugged tight, sharing the warmth, sharing the only thing any of us have to share on this earth when you think about it. And then you toppled us on the snow, you devil. We laughed and rolled around, my head already spinning from the wine and crisp, pure night air and the stillness all around. We lay back and I gasped when I realized what I was seeing. The luminous starscape, like a vast velvet cloth sprinkled with powdered sugar, like it can only be seen in the countryside. I had tears in my eyes when I turned to you and we kissed, and it felt like the only moment in all of time, or outside time, and ours was the only spark that could ignite the universe. You gave me these moments. You complete me in ways I never knew to dream of. Let me be the one who makes sense of the confusion whenever you feel lost again. We can make our own world against the rest of the world if need be. Together we can silence all the demons, heal all the wounds. I love you. In eternity yours, Serena.
Yeah.
I should look around some more. I have to remember her face. There's a strand of blonde hair in the comb. Yes, blonde hair like sun rays. I'm remembering. What's wrong with my memory? Did I have a stroke? She also had a brush, but I can't see it anywhere. Nor some of her other personal items. It's just a regular comb bought from a supermarket, new enough to still have all its teeth.
Okay.
Pretty shambolic, isn't it? The organization of its contents isn't much better. It'd be a shame to say we're fashionistas. We were never that big on appearance. Serena has this mystical aura about her, even when she's wearing one of my mom's charming knitted sweaters. I do remember that on the night I first met her, she wore this beautiful purple dress, like she'd flown straight down from the night sky. I wonder what became of that dress. This dresser contains most of her things. There's mostly beauty products and personal items in it. Just girly stuff of no interest to me. My kind of thing is the bookcase near the table. This dresser contains most of her things.
So, dann wollen wir mal gucken, ob wir uns schon wieder dran erinnern können. Ah ja.
This was taken on that crisp winter night at our mutual friend's hunting lodge. We came back indoors, laughing, giddy as teenagers. It was truly like an enchanted time, like we were in a magic circle where no sorrow or pain could touch us. My love, we don't have a lot of photos of ourselves as a couple, so this one is quite important.
Ja, so glücklich sieht sie nun auch wieder nicht aus.
The guy who snapped this, our host that night, used an actual film camera. It was a different world back then. My love,
Okay.
How long has it been, I wonder? I can't tell. I miss her so much. That ticking, it never stops. I've wasted so much time in my life. Did I ever take a break to show her how much I truly cared? Actually, I think it might have gone out of sync again. No trusting this clock. I wonder what time it is. As always, I automatically went to the window side, and she took the one by the armoire. Some of her scent still lingers. What's the matter with me? I can't seem to remember even ordinary things. When was the last time we made love? Maybe if I go to sleep, I'll wake up, and there she'll be, arms wrapped around me, the warm and passionate touch of her lips. I can't sleep. It feels as if I've been awake for ages. I feel too restless to sleep right now.
Mal gucken, können wir jetzt schon diese komische Truhe öffnen?
Is there anything worse than beautiful memories turning to dust? I feel like I don't even have the strength to lift the lid. Why? I might just as well stay here. I should really stay. I'm so tired anyway. I prefer the darkness inside right now.
Okay, dann gehen wir mal wieder zum Bücherregal.
Someone said, work and love are the only things that ever really happened to us. Was it Freud or Marilyn Monroe? Did I let my work destroy my love? Writing was so all-consuming for me, yet I made so little headway in all this time. It all seems so meaningless now, drained of everything that made it worth reading in the first place. A lot of rarities and special editions here.
Also wie das aussieht, darf ich jetzt alles nochmal neu abklappern.
I didn't lend out my Necronomicon, did I? No.
Come sit with me. I want to talk. There's something I have to tell you.
Oh, das ist neu.
I have been trying, and believe me, I've been trying so hard.
I almost have it. What was she trying to tell me? I can imagine her cuddling up to me even now, putting her hand under my shirt.
Na, das passt jetzt nicht so da rein.
Of course, we made love here, too. There was no place in the cabin we didn't before things deteriorated. The most comfortable spot in the cabin. Well, along with the bed, of course.
Ein wenig schizophren.
Without any activity, the corner feels cold and lifeless. I'd give anything to see her standing here again, making coffee or sandwiches. I made my own too, of course, but it just made me happy to see.
Also diese Uhr scheint...
I didn't cook much for her. Always so worried about my stuff.
Okay. Gehen wir nochmal zum Bild. Oh. Ist doch ganz so glücklich.
She's angry now. Part of me realizes I should be more shocked by this, but for some reason, I just feel numb. Beyond it. She was lying to me and manipulating me all the time. Why did I let her do that? I'm the one who should have been scowling. She played me like a harp and made me look like a complete idiot. All of this, these pathetic souvenirs from our relationship, they're all lies. I couldn't care less about this damn thing. I torture myself trying to remember. I'm too upset to even think straight.
Whoa.
I hate her so much. All of
okay.
this, these pathetic souvenirs from our relationship, they're all lies.
Das ist natürlich jetzt ein Umschwung.
Sit down, we need to talk.
When did it go so wrong? This was supposed to be a... We weren't supposed to fight here.
You just don't get it, do you? You never do.
I couldn't care less about this damn thing. I torture myself trying to remember. Changeable man, insolent wretch. Sounds like Serena, all right. Her father's realm. She was a daughter of the Celtic sea god Manannan. What was it? Maklura? Scholars say Niav's divine father, Manannan, was of an elder race even more ancient than the Tuatha-Dé Danann. Too upset to even think straight. I hate her so much. All of this, these pathetic souvenirs from our relationship, they're all lies.
Okay.
All the real color faded from it long ago. It must be full of dust mites. I should burn it. I told her the rug was fine work, like I know anything about handicrafts. But it's what the Empress wanted to hear, wasn't it? I couldn't care less about this damn thing. The stains on this bed suddenly make me mad. Angry, even. Why must life always end up so sordid and hateful? I'm not crawling in there. I'm too riled up for that, and it's just not dark enough anyway. Why torture myself trying to remember? I should tear all her filthy, disease-ridden clothes apart and burn them! Everything she wore, just to lure me in. Not even these violent impulses give me the strength I need to open the armoire! What is wrong with me? I'm too upset to even think straight. How could I be so inconsiderate? Did this stupid lamp destroy my marriage? I will fix it. In case she comes back.
Natürlich.
I haven't got any bulbs on me, and I didn't bring any tools. Wait, what am I thinking? Why am I worrying about a stupid lamp? I hate her so much. It's finally sinking in. She's not coming back. Nothing in this cabin will ever change again unless it's by my hand.
We don't have any more light bulbs. I'm sick of this thing anyway. We're chipping away at what little money we have because of a piece of junk.
All of this, these pathetic souvenirs from our relationship, it's just a book. What good will reading a fairy tale do me? God has never been there for me when I needed comfort. Why would he want to go out of his mysterious ways to help me now? I couldn't care less about this damn stupid, feeble-minded woman with her silly, menial things. It was she who didn't deserve me. I wouldn't waste my intellect on this sublunary distraction. She probably cared more for this plant than she cared for me. Why torture myself trying to remember?
Okay, wir haben da wohl einen kleinen Missstand aufgedeckt.
It feels darker by the minute, but the sun is still high in the sky. Or is it? I feel so turned around. It can't be happening. No. I can still see, even if the light is going. I'm not turning it on. I'm too upset to even think straight.
Why must I always be the one to fill the damn pitcher?
When did the place get so out of hand? I hate dust, and so did she, but here's a whole freaking cake of it! If I kicked the nightstand, the dust would billow up and swallow me like a desert storm. I hate her so much.
Nope, hier ist auch nichts mehr drin.
That incessant noise! I should smash this useless antique to pieces right now! It can't keep the time for 5 minutes straight. Chimes completely at random and never stops making that infernal noise. But hey, guess who thought it was so cute? This thing has caused me more sleepless nights than I care to remember. No wonder I'm going crazy. All of this, these pathetic souvenirs from our relationship, they're all lies.
Dearest, how do I say any of this? I like your way with words, but if I don't write this, I don't know what I'll do. My life feels so unreal now, dreamlike, but wonderfully so. Let me- And then you toppled us on the snow.
Okay, da hat sich nichts verändert. Auch nicht.
Where are you going? Oh, that's rich. Just run away.
I just needed to blow off steam to be somewhere else. Just for a while. But I can't even remember what we argued about. Unless she was the one who left. I couldn't care less about this damn thing. Why torture myself trying to remember? I tried to flush these a long time ago, but someone noticed, as if she cared about my impotent life. High blood pressure? What a load of bull. I've never felt better in my life.
I'm sick and tired of having to pamper you like a baby. Fine, I hope you have a great, lonely time at the hospital.
I'm too upset to even think straight. I can't even bear to look at my face. She's really done a number on me. She never descended to criticizing my looks, though. Even when we fought, even when my hairline started going. But it was a sore point for me. My thoughts are all over the place. Get it together, damn it. I hate her so much.
Natürlich.
How could I have been so blind? Her vanity. Always fixing her hair before bed. Doting on her hair like a child. But I'm being unfair. Would I have wanted her to be some frump? Ugh, I'm too angry to even care. All she cared about was herself all along. Her needs, her feelings. That's all that ever mattered to her. What about mine? All of this, these pathetic souvenirs from our relationship, they're all... Guess I could have thanked that heartless slut at least once whenever she covered up her body. No, this isn't like me. I must calm down. If anyone is to be blamed, that's me. This ugly old thing makes me feel sick. I couldn't care less about this damn thing.
Mal gucken, was haben wir das Bild an. Also das schreit quasi nach einer Paartherapeut. Oh ja.
Why torture myself trying to remember?
Okay, da war nichts Neues. Also Paartherapie wäre mal angebracht. Kriegen wir die Kiste jetzt auf? Ah.
I sit here on the train, taking me to my final farewell to the ones who brought me to this world. I see the smiling couples on their way to new adventures and think, that used to be us. We had joy and laughter and friends once, but a memory is not the thing itself. You're very good at letting things you don't want to face slip off you. You continue as if nothing has changed, lost in your own lifeless world. Words and dreams may be enough for you. You know what? You'll get a chance to test that soon. I question how I once saw things. How much of what I thought we had were my own feelings, and how much of your manipulation? Because you are so very good with words, aren't you? You knew how to use them when we met, and for the longest time, I went along with the romantic whirl you conjured up around our shabby, isolated existence. Oh, it took me long enough to see it for what it was. And there were these moments that you swept me off on foolish flights of fancy, when I threw myself into your fantasies. You wove your spell, plying me with your magic and with wine in equal measure, and I was taken in like the lost little girl I was. Do you realize all the pain you've caused me? They say if you have to ask whether someone loves you, you already know the answer. Protestations to the contrary can no more convince me anymore than I can make my own mother or father draw breath again. Your aloofness tells a different story. I no longer know what you're thinking. With my parents gone and with your refusal to even accompany me in my time of need, something broke. Or maybe it happened long ago, but I never saw it so clearly before, even after everything. I don't make you feel comfortable? Really? That's all you have to say? I won't waste any more life waiting for things that'll never come. Of course, that's what you expect me to do. Play the good wife so no one will laugh at you for being the failure you are, to shield you from the truth of your existence. Lost in your books and vapid verse, blithely drifting into the mists of time, as if not even a footnote, when you could be raking at it if you'd only used your words for anything other than personal indulgence. You talked and talked about your path, the winter blueness of my eyes, all that nonsense. And the years rolled by, the seasons came and went, on and on. You pursuing your dreams that will never be. Lost in your damned words, looking for clues you'll never find. I'm sure you're doing it even now with your rotting books. You took the best years of my life, and gave only empty words in return. We've gone as far as we can, and something's got to give.
The jewelry box. What is it doing here?
Okay.
It's just a bunch of schmaltzy junk. A shrine to naivety. I don't see anything else of value. I should just destroy this useless junk, but not even the venom inside me gives me strength. I'm too upset to even think straight.
Gut, also das Geschmeide haben wir aufgesammelt. Guck. Nope. Also das hört sich doch schwer nach einer Ehekrise.
I hate her so much.
Okay.
All of this, these pathetic. I couldn't care less about this damn thing. Why torture myself trying to remember? I'm too upset to even think straight.
Okay. Come on.
A part of me still thinks she'll forgive me and come back. But I've lost all hope now. Do I deserve to be forgiven? What about all the things she did, and all the things she said?
Words and dreams may be enough for you, but you know what? You'll get a chance to test that soon, because I've had enough.
I hate her so much.
Okay.
It's like looking into my own soul right now. Did I see shadows move? No. Just my imagination. It's like the whole world is against me. Even my mind is playing tricks on me. All of this, this armchair, this is where we had that talk, that damn...
I've been trying so hard, but we lost something along the way. Did you get my letter? Will you just listen to me for once? God, you're always... Wait, where are you going? Don't walk away from me.
I couldn't care less about this damn thing. I tried to be charitable with her, but what did it get me? Honestly, she could rarely carry a tune, so her humming habit got on my nerves. My wife has no indulgence given except what comes to her from heaven. We eat little, we drink less. This earth breeds not our happiness. William Blake. Never those dry, blackened omelets again. Good riddance. Why torture myself trying to remember? I want to hurl the whole damn lot into the lake. Or just tear at the pages until the wind sweeps them away. Some of these started to mildew long ago. Nothing gold can stay. Frost. Oh, those words. Those damn words. My whole life's been consumed by them. Now I have none left to say. I'm too upset to even think straight. I hate her so much.
Okay.
All of this, these pathetic souvenirs from our relationship, they're all lies. Sunlight, birdsong. Nothing feels worse when there's no hope, no chance of anything. The light is so dim here. Makes me want to chop down every tree outside. There's only a limited window of opportunity for everything. And I wasted mine. I couldn't care less about this damn thing. Why torture myself trying to remember? I'm too upset to even think. I hate her so much. all of this, these pathetic souvenirs from our relationship, they're all lies. I couldn't care less about this damn thing.
Okay, ich habe ja diese komische Dose aufgesammelt.
Yes, go ahead and empty the whole salt shaker on your meal. I hope you choke.
She was always yammering about the salt, feigning concern about my blood pressure. Should have emptied this into her lying throat till she vomited. If she were here, I'd rub salt into her wounds, all right, just like she's rubbed salt into mine. Why torture myself trying to remember? Truth is, I could have used this spice to get some of her abominations down my throat. She never had any sense for balancing a meal. It was either spicy hot or cringeworthy bland. I was used to much better fare before my family fell on hard times. Almost empty. So typical of you, Serena. Not one limit. I'm too upset to even think straight. I hate her so much.
Ah, gut, habe ich die Kiste also draufgestellt. Ja, sie guckt immer noch so.
All of this, these pathetic souvenirs from our relationship, they're all lies.
Und der Ehering.
I remember how happy these made her. She smiled. That wonderful smile. I must have gifted these to make amends or something. Or did I? Did I ever gift her anything? She loved her trinkets more than she loved me. Right? I couldn't care less about this damn thing. Her wedding ring or mine? But what is it doing here? Oh, please, no. It's hers. I can't believe she would just leave it here. Where the hell is she? No. It can't be true. No. No, I didn't do it. I need to wake up from this nightmare. Why torture myself trying to remember?
Gut, vielleicht kriegen wir jetzt einen komischen Schrank auf. Wow.
We had a plan. I took measures to ensure nothing like this would happen. But no, we couldn't help your damn self.
Okay.
My God. What is this?
Don't worry.
It can't.
It's all covered.
It isn't.
You spent much time.
How did it happen? I can't remember.
Fire will do it.
It's been months since you.
It's already rotten beyond recognition. But how much time has passed? It's dry and withered. A body takes at least weeks to. How long has it been? I can't even remember how I did it. Maybe I didn't. Do I have brain damage? Honestly, I wouldn't be surprised.
Das könnte natürlich Serena sein.
How stupid this was. We had a plan. I took measures to ensure nothing like this would happen. But no, you couldn't help your damn self. We can't risk moving it now. The bulldozers are coming any minute.
Fire will do it.
Do you think they will buy it after all this time? It's been months since you...
Don't worry. It's all covered. He spent much time here.
Fine. Give me the kerosene.
Hallo?
Oh shit! We forgot your... It was so stupid to leave it. Why did you do that?
Can you calm down?
I couldn't bear to wear it any longer. It's in a safe place. We'll pick it from the ashes.
No. Not like this. Please. No.
Okay. Wenn ich raten müsste, würde ich sagen, die Leiche im Schrank war der Proband. Also, ja. Nur so. Ja, da fehlen mir jetzt etwas die Worte. Man könnte jetzt darüber philosophieren, aber dass da einige Probleme bezüglich der Ehe stattgefunden haben müssen, ja. Ja gut, das war Serena und ich freue mich auf jeden Fall schon auf Asylum und hoffe, das wird in ähnlicher Weise interessant und ja, mit dem Abspann soll es dann auch gewesen sein. Danke fürs Zuschauen und dann sieht man sich bestimmt bei Asylum wieder.